Before we start, I want you to hit that red subscribe button so that you never miss out on any of our videos. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to David Dodge. You may recognize Warren Buffett as being one of the most frugal billionaires there ever was or is. He lived in the same house since the 1960s, drove the same car himself for 12 years, and owned a flip phone until early 2020 when he traded it for an iPhone. Finally. With that being said, he is still a billionaire, and here are 10 things he owns that cost more than you may see in your life. Number 1, American Express. In the 1960s, American Express stocks were down, prompting Buffett to buy his first ever stock in his 30s. Miraculously, the company survived and continued to run smoothly, even going as far as outperforming competitors. In the end of 2013, Buffett owned about 14.2% of American Express, which we can guarantee is a lot of money. 2. Private jet. When Buffett finally became a face many recognized, his ability of traveling in regular passenger aircrafts was made difficult. To solve this issue, he purchased a private jet, which he justified by saying that he did a lot of traveling and the ticket costs had caught up to him in the past few years. Although most billionaires would buy a jet so they can sip champagne and fly to exotic lands, Buffett is not like most billionaires. For him, this purchase was about efficiency and saving time. How many of us can say we've even sat in a private jet, let alone bought one? 3. Coca-Cola. Buffett referred to himself as one quarter Coca-Cola in a magazine interview. At the time, he was not talking about the percentage of the company he owns, but about how much he consumes. Because of his love for the fizzy drink, he bought some shares of it and now owns about 9% of Coca-Cola, which is insane. When was the last time you bought a company's stocks because you liked their products? 4. Amazon. I don't think Amazon needs an introduction. We all know what it is and who it is owned by. Jeff Bezos, the richest man in the world. It doesn't really come as a shock that Buffett owns upwards $530,000 worth of Amazon shares. According to the man in question, he stated that while it wasn't him directly purchasing the stock, he was glad his two employees had, since it had been very profitable since. Many of us can't even afford Amazon Prime. Can't imagine buying parts of Amazon itself. Number 5, Dairy Queen. Berkshire Holdings bought Dairy Queen for $585 million back in the late 90s. Now, every time you go to purchase a Blizzard, just know that all of that money is being pocketed by none other than Warren Buffett. The amount he paid for the ice cream chain is enormous, especially taking into account the economy during the 90s, which is much different from the economy now. Oh, did I mention he also paid for it in cash? I've never even seen that much cash in my life. Number 6, Nebraska Furniture Mart. As most of the investments on this list go, Buffett was intrigued by the furniture store in the 90s. Upon conversing with the owner and discussing the amount she'd sell for, Rose Bumpkin, the owner, parted with Nebraska Furniture Mart for $60 million. Within moments, Buffett became the owner of a multi-million dollar furniture shop. 7, NetJets. Earlier, we talked about Buffett purchasing a single jet for himself to make his life easier. His newfound love for jets led him to buy NetJets, which was then a struggling private jet service offering executive jets. He paid a handsome $725 million, and today, NetJets has become the unquestionable leader in the marketplace for jets. Not only can we not imagine buying our own jet, it's unfathomable to think of buying a private jet company. Number 8, Apple. Steve Jobs' Apple will never need a description because everyone has heard of it, and millions of people across the globe own Apple products. Judging by Apple's success over the years, Buffett must have believed it to be lucrative, leading him to purchase $254 million worth of stocks, which have nearly doubled within the years he's owned them. Not only is he being paid Apple quarterly payout, which is 77 cents per share, he has also made a $30 million profit so far. People around the world are selling their possessions to afford the latest iPhones, but here's Buffett, who literally owns part of Apple. 9. Wells Fargo & Company. Buffett's stake in the bank cost him $19.8 billion. He was persuaded to purchase these shares since Wells Fargo is considered one of the big four banks in the United States right now. Owning parts of a bank is something many of us have never thought of. Some may not have known that it was even possible. But Buffett clearly knows everything. That's probably why he's a billionaire. Number 10, Duracell batteries. While things go in and out of fashion, one thing Buffett will not have to worry about for a while are batteries going out of style. To this day, numerous appliances need batteries, and the most trusted batteries are those of Duracell. In 2014, Procter & Gamble exchanged Duracell for the 4.7 billion shares they owned. Buffett gave them back their stocks, and he then owned all of Duracell. This brings us to the end of our video. I hope you enjoyed it. Hit like if you did, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss any of our videos in the future. Also, watch the two videos that are on your screen because I'm sure you'll love them. With that, I'll see you in the next video.